So what's going on, tool groupies? Hope your all's day has been as well as mine. Been busy doing a little bit of everything as usual. But let me show you, instead of all this talking, let me just show you some of the odd jobs that I've been doing throughout today and, well, last few days. So this is one of the problems. I got a call in today and I found out what the issue was. As you can see right here, there's a keyway, but no key. No key. It appears to, halfway be on here. It's a little bit loose and that's never a good thing. And if you roll it around to the back side here, you'll see that whoever put this on here clearly didn't know what the hell they were doing, because they didn't even put a key in it. I mean, there's no key. No key. It's not even lined up straight, because the actual key slot's over here, and here's the keyway right there on the sprocket. And we got a Allen fastener hole right here. And it should be one more around here. Run right over here. So, we'll have to check and see if that's actually got a little hex screw in it that does. We'll take them out. I'm assuming that somebody run them in there thinking that that's what held it on here, and then we'll try to get this thing fixed back up. Without a bullet. Problem is somebody tightened that damn thing up so tight that it could not get that screw out. You can see that set screw is way up in there. Where this thing has been cocked on there a little bit. So I'm gonna make sure to check the oil. We got an oil plug right up top here, and then we've got this drain hole right here so we can drain the oil, change it, or we can just check the fluid level right here, make sure it's got oil in it. I'm going to put my stethoscopes on here and turn it just to make sure everything sounds good before we reassemble everything.
Says we got some new keys right here, different size keys right here. It's nice and small, but we're going to go ahead and make sure I got this shaft cleaned out real good. We done got our sprocket nice and cleaned off, worked out. We got our 1/8 set screws here. We've also got our little bond huss T-way. It's gonna be lined up. You want it to be fairly even. This thing, the chain is too long to begin with. This is just way too long. And I got a chain breaker. We go grab it, cut it in half real easy. Basically set this where you want it at. These are supposed to provide tension back and forth. You can see right there, it's got a spring. It's spring loaded here, so once you set that tension, it should bounce back and forth. Now, this could be tightened up a little bit further. We might take a link out of that here later. Got the sprocket on. The key is on there properly. Got both of the Allen or hex
screws back in there. That way they're nice and set up. Got this little adjustment tensioner here set up. We will definitely go ahead and take out one or two links and adjust that. Get that back on there. Their machine kept kicking off and it kept saying motor overload and wouldn't let them restart it, kept kicking the circuit breakers, all that kind of stuff. Come in, you know, the contactor, check the voltage, all that sort of things. And now it's the process of elimination. Got the motor pulled off there. They said that they didn't think that it took oil, but it does take oil. So the first thing I done was make sure to check and add the oil to that thing and then run power to it, make sure it was getting the power that it's supposed to between the contactors and all that stuff. And it's actually coming on now. So next scenario is come here, make sure that there's no binding with the chain, with any of the bearings, the belts on this thing, get all this stuff serviced up. And then I'm going to reassemble it. I'm going to get our motor back on, and afterwards I am going to take apart the contactor and check it out, make sure it's working, functioning properly, because it could be engaging and disengaging prematurely, getting hot, something like that. We do got one on hand in my service truck, so I'll bring it in here and we'll go ahead and swap it out if we need to. But that is what I'm doing today. Of course, I'm packing around this new little set of gear wrench tools that I've had for about a month or two now. And I'm also trying out some of these tools here that I've done reviews on. The Job Smart Ratchet looks like a rebranded gear wrench. Trying out some of these old basic Pittsburgh sockets here. And some of these little hyper tough ratchets, just to see how they hold up or not.